Okay, awesome. You've handled load and considered what you might do during periods of idle time. But what next? Well, the user is going to interact with the app, and you need to be responsive to that. This isn't responsive in the sense that it responds to screens of different sizes. This is responsive in the sense that it reacts to the user input without delay. Well, how responsive does it need to be then? Well, studies show that there is a limit of 100 milliseconds, so a tenth of a second, after someone presses something on screen before they notice any lag. So if you can respond to all user input in that time, you're good to go. That's great if the thing they did was to, say, toggle a checkbox or tap a button, and you show a single change like a selected state. But there's another version of this, which is more challenging, which is that the user does something that requires animation. The most challenging performance issues always come out of the need to hit 60 frames a second, which is either interactions that stick to the user's finger or transitions and animations. For those, we have a limit of 16 milliseconds, which is 1 second or 1,000 milliseconds divided by 60. In reality, we actually have less than 16 milliseconds because the browser has overhead. And so really, we get around 10 to 12 milliseconds. That's not a lot of time.